Only recently have I liked doing my hair. Well, not really this part.
It's 4:45 and I'm up so I can do my hair before my 8 a.m. class today.
Or this part. But I do really like this part.
Oh, that's a pretty curl.
And I'm not alone. Every day on my college campus or just out in public, I see so many Black women wearing their hair natural, more than ever before. So what happened? Because we all know things never used to be this way.
I remember sitting in the kitchen for what seemed like all day while my mother did my hair. Today it's a lot easier, thanks to PCJ Original Formula Relaxer with NutriSheen.
Nearly every Black woman at some point in their lives wanted to wear their hair regularly straight.
Because it wasn't just a hairstyle. It brought you job security.
A former television news anchor in Mississippi, Noble started wearing her hair naturally after she became pregnant with her son. Noble was fired a month later.
Self-esteem?
Mom? Yes, dear?
Mama, I want soft and beautiful hair just like yours.
And it made white people more comfortable around you.
If your hair is relaxed, white people are relaxed. If your hair is nappy, they're not happy.
Straight hair helped avoid at least some negative attention in a violently racist society. But the only reason I can tell you this story today, while doing my natural hair in my college dorm bathroom, is because things are changing.
Today's video, as you can see by the title, is another hair video.
I'm gonna show you guys from start to finish all the products that I've been using.
So I'm gonna show you how I've been styling my hair lately.
We are going to be pampering the natural hair.
There are not only the right kinds of curly hair products on the market today, but there is a whole community or movement to teach Black women how to take care of their natural, beautifully curly and coily hair. But the curly hair products we have today and this movement wasn't built overnight. The clearest start to the natural hair care movement begins with Madam C.J. Walker, the first Black woman millionaire in America's history due to her successful homemade line of hair care products. Madam C.J. Walker's passion for this business derived from her severe hair loss. Hair loss at the time was common for Black women. Many families lived without indoor plumbing, so regular shampooing wasn't possible. And problems like lice and pollutants went untreated. In addition, many Black women used straightening products known as ox marrow pomade that promised to soften and straighten the hair, but it really just did a lot of heavy damage on the scalps. So Madam C.J. Walker started to treat her hair loss with some home remedies.
Like oils, butters.
And you know what else? Give me a little Dixie cup full of lard.
But one night in 1906, after all the hours and trials she spent mixing products, the formula for her groundbreaking design came to her in a dream. She described the dream as a big Black man appeared to me and told me what to mix up for my hair. I dream about big Black men too, Madam Walker. Heard. Her creation was called Madam Walker's Wonderful Hair Grower. The thing about Madam C.J. Walker is her products weren't intended for Black women to wear their natural curls out per se, but rather it was intended to soothe the itchy scalp and grow their hair back. She says she wanted her products to benefit Black women, not change them. Her advertisements were much kinder to Black women and their appearance than any of the ads we have seen up until this point. Manufacturers from products like Curl One Cure, a cure for the curls, told Black women to chemically straighten their hair in order to be accepted by society. They even threw a free skin lightener in as a bonus, promising that you would be transformed from this black blob into looking like a founding father. Other ads made it seem like our hair was uncombable, thus we had to chemically straighten it. And some literally just said that we were so fucking ugly, and as courtesy to others around you, get rid of your curls. But C.J. Walker's ads didn't say any of this. She emphasized that hair is confidence and that her products encouraged women to not only grow more healthy hair, but that if you sold her products, you could be economically independent like her. Her business employed over 100,000 sales agents that went door to door selling her products. And while C.J. Walker still agreed that Black women must have straight hair in order to be accepted in society, She just wanted you to do it safely. So she designed the Walker method, which mainstreams the hot comb. The Walker method started out with washing your hair with her vegetable shampoo, and then applying like a pomade, which is like a grease to help hold your hair down when you apply the third step, the hot comb. Since CJ Walker's passing in 1909, society kept her hot comb. A straight hair basically meant you were middle class or wealthy. But her hair products weren't the only ones on the market now to keep your natural hair healthy. Magazines like Ebony helped me to see all the new hair care products on the markets from the 1940s up until the 1990s. Across the decades, there were always products to help treat dandruff and dry, itchy scalps. Many products began to help us condition our hair to prevent it from becoming dry and brittle and help moisturize it and grow longer. Before the 70s, a portion of these ads were small and mainly covered up by relaxer ads, which is a product used to keep black people's hair permanently straight. And the ads continued to label curly hair as problem hair. The front cover of one of the magazines in the early 60s straight up asked if Negro women are getting prettier, as all the light skin and mixed girls with wigs on their heads or their hair relaxed said that our new peaks of attractiveness was an exciting new breed. Flipping through the magazines in the 60s and 70s, I saw so many more hair products to help nourish the afro.
Because we are in the era of the Black Power movement.
We had Black Panthers fighting for freedom across America. Angela Davis just went to prison. Black people all across the country were organizing to be politically, culturally, and economically free from white America. At the same time, it instilled a sense of pride in black people who began to further embrace black art, history, and pride, especially through the hair. Thus, products started to cater to the movement. Products like Proline, Afro Sheen, and Vitapoint were products that helped hold the afro's shape and keep them nourished and looking glossy. But as afros quickly made you become a political target, our curls for the first time were starting to make an appearance. Well, kind of. In the 80s, Michael Jackson helped to popularize the Jerry curl with his new Thriller album. And it became the cultural staple for the black community. The reason I say this is kind of a win is because what you're seeing is not our natural hair that is nourished with healthy hair products. The Jerry curl is the same chemicals in a relaxer, but instead of the end result being straight, it's curly. But a form of curls could only be tolerated for a short amount of time. And after the 80s, we returned to bone straight hair. And of course, our community had a variety of different hairstyles, like braids and whatnot. But what has always been acceptable is straight hair. Until recently.
I'm going to big chop my hair today. Today's the day.
I'm about to start chopping my freaking hair off.
I'm gonna just do it straight off pure adrenaline right now.
I'm really excited to do this actually because I miss my curls. I've learned that my hair is gonna grow back. Okay, I'm not afraid to do this. If I give love to certain things in my life, then I know it'll grow.
The natural hair movement began in 2010 with videos all across YouTube showing black women doing the big chop.
Wait, this is crazy!
This is where they would cut off all the chemically damaged or flat iron damaged parts of their hair.
So my damaged curls down here and then like my real hair texture up here.
And allow the regrowth of their natural hair pattern.
The big chop is like a symbol of regrowth or renewal. Cutting off the hair that felt like was weighing them down and to start fresh and care for the curls that they were born with. The natural hair movement happened because of black women doing their hair on camera and posting it on YouTube.
Access to the internet allowed for women to learn from each other from any part in the country.
The movement started teaching black women how to take care of their natural hair and to make it as healthy as possible. And it all came down to a routine.
It's been a long time since I filmed a wash day routine video for you guys.
Black women started using the term wash day, which is a day where you clean your hair thoroughly and apply all of your curly hair products and let it sit in that style for the next 3 to 5 days. And the end result is called a wash and go. And that's exactly what I'm doing to my hair right now. But the natural hair community also is teaching you, you don't have to do your hair that way either. You can do twist outs, braid outs, or any other kind of natural hairstyle, and to just rock with whatever natural style you like and your hair likes the most. What was especially important about this movement is Black women were being taught what kind of curly hair they had. The chart ranges from 2A, which is like wavy hair, all the way to 4C, which is very tight curls or coils that is usually shrunken from the actual length that it is. While this movement was huge for forcing beauty corporations to start creating products that worked with our natural hair rather than against it, the women who were the face of this movement were still light skin or mixed girls with 2B to 3B type hair. But by 2019 and 2020, all of that started changing as my generation began a Black Power movement that mirrored what we saw in the 70s. And again, as the political climate shifted, so did our hair. And thankfully, Black people didn't have the same kind of aggressive target when we did our natural hair during this political climate like we had in the 70s. So when we were doing our hair and we could be out in public spaces and not feel like wearing our natural hair would round us up in prison, doing our natural hair just brought us more joy. Something that was also key to this movement is that COVID hit at like the exact same time. And as we were all shut inside, a new popular social media platform came out known as TikTok. And as TikTok got more popular, the natural hair community started shifting from making videos on YouTube to making our videos on TikTok. And as our community had a lot of time indoors, the natural hair movement started having more conversations surrounding colorism and texturism within the movement. Texturism is stigmatizing type 4 hair, specifically type 4C hair, and applying negative terms to it like nappy, unruly, or unmanageable. So in this new wave of natural hair movement, the type 4 hair creators on TikTok were saying that their hair needs to be celebrated too, because theirs is also beautiful. And if we're gonna have a natural hair movement, it needs to include everybody, not just the girls with the looser curls. In fact, because of these conversations, this is when I went natural as well. As a kid, the only time I let my hair out of the straightener or from my braids was on crazy hair days, because that's how I viewed my hair, just crazy. But because of this natural hair movement, I was able to learn that my hair is in the 3C to 4A category, and I just needed to give my hair the products for my hair type. In this new movement, you can literally search for every texture of hair. Since there are girls from every type posting their routines in their bathrooms or in their bedrooms, helping to teach you how to love your curls, your coils, and your texture. Products once advertised to Black women in the pages of Ebony are on the decline, as the natural hair movement is giving women more freedom that they haven't known for generations. The natural hair movement has changed laws.
The Crown Act, which prohibits race-based hair discrimination, was passed in California,
Connecticut.
Now that the Crown Act has passed the House,
created visible joy.
This is my natural state, and it's freaking gorgeous, and I'm gonna rock it and I'm gonna own it.
But I'm still gonna compliment the next Black woman that I see who's rocking their natural hair. And I'm gonna let her know that it's beautiful.
And is making sure that little girls will only have too many products to choose from. But this process to wear your natural curls is a journey that requires a lot of time and patience and love. But we do it because we're making up for lost time. Our hair deserves the kind words and nourishing products, the wonderful compliments, the pedestal. Because a part of us hopes that if we say how beautiful our hair is today and forever, the women who came before us will be able to hear it too. And besides, our curls always look the best when they know we have fallen in love with them. Okay, I got class. Thank you all for watching.